Greetings, dear participants of the conference. Allow me to introduce a report about basic concepts of geometric algebra and Grassmann GL package. At the beginning of the report, we briefly describe the basics of geometric algebra. Next, we give a number of examples to calculate the examples. We use Grassmann GL package and also show some formulas. This allows us to introduce also not only the theory but also some package capabilities. As the basic example, we consider rotation in the three-dimensional space and compare multivector with quaternions. The study of geometric algebra, we study geometric algebra because of its generalization power. We hope that it will be helpful in our study, in our scientific research. To automate the calculation, we choose the Grassmann GL package because we use Julia language in our work, and we decided to explore its main features, and the result of this study we present in this presentation. Exterior algebra is studied in an advanced course of linear and general algebra, so we will focus only on the basics. Contravariant skew-symmetric tensors or anti-symmetric tensors of type 0p are called p-vectors or polyvectors. Sometimes also the multivector term is used, but we use multivector to name another type of objects. If the rank is important, we can denote it as a subscript. The letter L will note vector space with basis E1 and En, and lambda P will be the linear space of P vectors. The outer product, or in other words, exterior product or wedge product can be defined through the tensor product, or it can be defined axiomatically. This slide lists the axioms so that it must satisfy, and the main feature it's important to note is the anticommutativity property for odd rank of the p vectors. If we construct lambda space, it's a space which is the result of direct sum of spaces of different rank. The outer product and on this space will give the structure of associative algebra, and this algebra is called the exterior algebra, or another term is Grassmann algebra. The polyvector can be decomposed according to the basis. The basis polyvectors are p vectors composed of the basic vectors of the space L. For a polyvector, where is the maximum rank vector n vector, if L space has dimension n, then n vector has only one component, and the basis n vector is only one also, and we denote it as E n, and it is called unit volume element. The only component of n vector is called also pseudoscalar or antiscalar. In this table you can see some examples. It is examples of L space of different dimension and possible rank of lambda spaces. Interesting two main facts, but two important facts. First, for every dimension of L, we have two type of objects, scalar and b-vector, and for example for 3 dimension scalar and 3 vector, for 4 dimension scalar and quadri-vector, and these objects have only one component, so we can construct b-action from scalar to b-vector, from scalar to 3 vector. Also, beginning from third dimension, there are at least two objects with the same rank, vector, b vector, vector, 3 vector, and so on. We can also construct b action from b vector to vector, from vector to 3 vector, and so on. This b action can be constructed using right complement and left complement operations. These operations we will use later in our examples. They allow make us such a bi-action between two elements with the same number of components. Let us now to introduce geometric algebra concepts. There are two main concepts, multivector and geometric product. The main object here is a multivector. A multivector is a complex object. It consists of different p-vectors from scalar to any p-vector. The plus sign here should be preserved as the complex numbers and quaternions. The geometric product operation we define only for vectors. Later, if we have orthonormal basis of the space L, then it's possible to derive formulas for the geometric products of any multivectors. The set of multivectors with geometric product gives us a Clifford algebra example, the algebra of multivectors. For geometric product, it's possible to define a division operation. And for orthonormal basis, we have following two very important properties. First, if we have two different vectors and find out the geometric multiplication, we'll see that this multiplication will be antisymmetric. If we multiply the same vector on itself, we have a scalar unit. Now about Grassmann-Gell model. Grassmann-Gell model is under heavy development, so it have a number of bugs. Some of them we find out in our study, and we note them in examples. Grassmann-Gell combines numerical computation with symbolic ones. For purely symbolic computation, it uses an external CAS reduce. Package can be used interactively. We use it with built-in Julia shell, but it's also possible to use it with Jupyter notebook or as a simple script. To write out simple scripts and run it with Julia compiler. Julia also actively uses Unicode characters. For example, if we want to input R letters to denote real numbers, we should use LaTeX macros, print BBR and type and press tab K. Now let us discuss this example. The slide shows an example of taking complements, right complement and left complement from an arbitrary vector. On the right you can see the code and on the left the formulas. The first line specifies the multivector space, but the basis is not exported to the main namespace. The basis is V1, V2, and V12 for two dimensions. We also can export these variables V1 and so on by using macros basis. With these macros, everything generated variables became available in the standard namespace. Next, you can see the right and left complements computation, but it's important to note that purely symbolic components in this operation will cause an error. This is obvious bug, and the author of this package knows about it. We find out that almost all basic operations do not work with purely symbolic coefficients, only with numerical. But only wage operation works as it should be. The example shows a rotation in two-dimensional Cartesian space, and it's obvious that it gives us a complex structure. Another example is signed area. This is generalization of signed area. We calculate it with using of wage operation. We take two vectors U and W, find out their outer product, and then right complement. Right complement gives us from B vector in two-dimensional space will give us a scalar value, and this scalar value will be the signed area. Vector product can be also find out as wage product and complement, right complement. It's enough to increase the dimension of the space, so the same operation gives us not an assigned area but a vector product. If we find out the multiplication of three vectors, not wage product of three vectors, and take a right complement, we will find out triple product. Here is it. In this example, we can use symbolic coefficients, but when we want to use complement right operation, it does not work. Another example is geometric product of two multivectors. Here is an example of multiplication. The main thing is to know about this operation is that if we have the decomposition of multivectors of the basis, we can use antisymmetry of different basis vectors and rearrange them and move the same vectors to each other, and they give us the scalar value. And in each term will remain only one type of basic vector. E1, E2, E3, only one type of each other. Another example, multivector of a special kind, of such kind, scalar path plus b vector in two dimension, are isometric to complex number. The role of imaginary unit in this case play the basis vector. The code is shown below, and there are some drawbacks in this code at line 5. If we use here integer coefficient, we will have error because of a bug in Grassmann GL module. Some more examples of imaginary unit as basis B vector. And then if we increase the dimension, if we increase the dimension of the space L at the same object, we'll now represent not complex numbers but quaternions. The B vector path became sum of three components, not only one, and every basis B vector now will represent imaginary units of a quaternion. The multiplication table is here, and we can calculate it with Grassmann GL package. Here is some code which give us this multiplication table. A few words about quaternions. Quaternions are hypercomplex numbers. So if we want to rotate some vector, for example vector v, we consider this vector as pure quaternion and multiply it from left and from right by some quaternion q. The vector part of this quaternion will be denoted as u, and this will be axis of rotation. So this operation will rotate the vector v around x u by the angle 2 theta, double theta. But it's a very common operation, and quaternions are the standard way to rotate vectors, but there are some difficulties. First, it's difficult to give a geometric interpretation of the angle theta. It's also not clear why this sandwich operation works, why this operation gives us a rotation of the vector. It's also not there is no straightforward generalization to larger dimensions. Now let us consider same operation but with multivectors. If we multiply some vector v by the vector a, and from the left, and its inverse from the right, we will get the reflection of the vector relative to the vector a. In this case of the normalized vector a, the formula will, in the case of normalized vector a, the formula will be even more simple. On this figure, you can see the geometric interpretation of this action. It's almost clear. Now, if we make two reflections respect with vector A and then with vector B, we see that we have a rotation of vector V. Vector v will rotate parallel to plane AB, the B vector AB or BA, define a plane, and the vector v will rotate parallel to that plane, and the angle of rotation will be doubled angle between vectors vector A and vector B. The multiplication of B and A is denoted as R, and this multivector is called rotor. If we define such such multivector, it has scalar part and B vector part, we can use it to rotate any vector to any angle. The formula for rotation is valid for any dimension of space. It's, we can use the same formula for rotating not only vectors but also multivectors. Also, this formula can be used for 4 dimension, 5 dimension, and so on. Besides that, it has very clear geometric interpretation. The angle theta has also clear geometric meaning, and sandwich operation also is clear why this operation works. Now let us consider some example. If we choose an axis of rotation U and rotate the ort E1 around this axis by the angle of 2π divided by 3, we will get as result the ort E2. Now if we have rotation x, we can find out the plane, the b vector of rotation. We should take a right complement from vector u, then we get the rotation plane, and then we can construct a rotor using trigonometric form of the multivector. It's very similar to quaternion, but have another sign. And now, then we construct this multivector. We can multiply ort E2. Here is some mistake. Here should be E2 vector. And when we multiply it by R, we will get a rotation, and we will get a vector E1. We must multiply here E1, and when we get E2. Some code shows these examples. We introduce vector U, then find its right complement, construct rotor, and act on ort V1 or E1 by this rotor, and get ort V2, E2. You can see it's 0, 0, 0, and only here the coefficient is 1. So the conclusion, we give a brief overview of the basic features of Grassmann package. The package has a number of bugs, but even in this stage it has well done functionality and great capabilities to solve some geometric algebra problems. Also, we give a comparing quaternions and multivectors, and we show some features of multivectors which make them better tool to make rotation in 3D space. Thank you for your attention.